I never know why you don't know how to tell the truth. You don't know how to tell the truth. Yeah. I'm a fool, fool. I've been such a fool. I'm blowing my cool with you right now.
These men is his own uncle. What is your name, please?
My name is Renato O'Neill.
My name is Renato O'Neill.
My name is Renato O'Neill.
Only one of these men is the real Renato O'Neill. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Peggy Cass, Barry Nelson, and Kitty Carlisle. On to Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Thank you, and welcome once again to Tell the Truth.
Good evening, panel.
Good evening.
Hey, all looks so great tonight. Ready for some fun? We have a lot of it here for you. Would you kindly open up your envelope for the first time, take out your affidavit cards, and follow along as I read from this first one of mine. I, Renato O'Neill, am Italian by birth, Irish by name, and a United States Marine by choice. 10 years ago, in Italy, I saw John Wayne in a movie glorifying the U.S. Marines. I determined then and there that somehow I would join the Corps. I applied for a visa to the States and was told that with a little luck, I might be admitted in 1999. I figured by that time I would be 60 and a bit old for Marine boot camp. Then I got a wild idea. My sister had married an American named O'Neill. If she and her husband could legally adopt me, I could get to the States immediately. It took an act of Congress, but my idea paid off. I came to this country as my sister's adopted son. And on March 29th, 1963, I took my oath of enlistment as a United States Marine. Signed, Renato O'Neill. We start things off tonight with three gentlemen, all claiming to be Renato O'Neill, United States Marine, who came about it in an interesting way. I think let's start the questioning with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. Number one, where were you born in Italy?
Trieste.
Number two, where were you born?
Trento.
Uh-oh, there we go. Number three, what is the first line of the Marine hymn?
I don't know, ma'am.
Do you know number one?
To the shore... I don't remember.
You don't remember. Do you know where Tripoli is, number two?
Yes, North Africa.
Thank you. Number three, where did you take your oath of enlistment?
In Louisville, Kentucky.
Number one, who is the head of the Marine Corps?
General Shoup.
General Shoup. Number two, do you agree with that?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
And number three, when you took...
Tom.
Thank you. Number two... Have you ever seen any other motion pictures that influenced the rest of your life?
Yes.
I mean, you better not see any with Sophia Loren or... what other movies did you see that influenced your...
I thought you were speaking about Marine.
Oh, the more Marine movies you saw that you liked?
Yes, I saw a couple more, yes.
Thank you. Number three, there's a province in Italy where the people have a different accent from others. Where is that? Do you know?
There is 21 different dialects in Italy, sir.
This one is quite extreme. Thank you.
Number three, where is Sorrento? Where is the nearest big city?
Naples.
Number three again. How did the Marine Corps differ from the version that you got watching those moving pictures?
Very much, sir.
Reality came to you. How long did the training take in boot camp?
11 weeks, sir.
Number one, what kind of a rifle do they use in the Marines now?
M1, sir.
M1.
And that's all the time we have. We come up to the moment when we mark ballots, so will you kindly do so immediately?
without change, and of course, no consultation, as you vote now for number one, number two, or number three. Our team of challengers will, of course, receive $250 for each and every incorrect vote indulged in by the panelists. Are all ballots marked?
I am marked.
Tom?
Oh, Mark.
Mark yours, and then practically immediately tell us for whom you voted.
I'm really worried about this one. I figured that he should have known, number three should have known the first line of the Marine hymn. Anyway, but there was something nice about the way he said, it's very different from the movie. So I voted for number three.
So I voted for number one.
All right, Kitty?
I voted for number one. I didn't ask number two the first line of Marine hymn, but number three didn't know it, and number two gave me the second line, which is pretty good for a guy who just got here a little while ago. And anyway, I think he would more identify with John Wayne. He looks more of the type.
All right, it's double and double, and it's two for three and two for one as we come up to our moment of truth to learn which of these gentlemen actually is the United States Marine who joined it in a very roundabout way. Will the real Renato O'Neill please stand up? Very good. Thank you very much, sir.
I love your hometown.
Congratulations to you. Anybody that wants anything that hard and is that enterprising ought to make a good Marine. We're very proud to have you in this country, believe me.
This famous photograph was taken by one of these men. What is your name, please?
My name is Joe Rosenthal.
My name is Joe Rosenthal.
My name is Joe Rosenthal.
Only one of these men is the real Joe Rosenthal. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, hostess of the new CBS radio show Woman's World, Miss Betty Furness, Johnny Carson, and Peggy Katz.
Good evening, panel.
Hi, Bud.
Hi, Bud.
Betty, great pleasure to welcome you back to our show.
Thank you, Bud. It's nice to be here.
And will you all kindly open up your envelopes, take out your affidavit cards for the first time, and follow along as I read from mine. I, Joe Rosenthal, am a newspaper photographer. During World War II, I was assigned to the Pacific area by the Associated Press. I made landings with the Marines on Guam, Peleliu, and Iwo Jima. It was on Iwo Jima that I shot my most memorable picture. This picture became one of the most reproduced photographs of all time. It won a Pulitzer Prize, was reproduced on a 3-cent postage stamp, and was also copied for a monument, which now stands on the bank of the Potomac River in Washington, D.C. I am the man who took the famous picture of the Marines raising the Stars and Stripes over Iwo Jima, signed Joe Rosenthal. Quite comfortable, gentlemen?
Yes, thank you.
All right, panel, you heard all three of these gentlemen claiming to be the photographer extraordinary Joe Rosenthal. Let's start this questioning with Tom Poston. Tom?
Thank you, Bud. Number two, it says Marines. I thought that was the Air Force that lifted that flag there.
No, it was Marines.
It was Marines. I just wanted to get a little plug for my service. No, I knew it was Marines. Number two, what famous American, what American was part of the flag-raising team there whose story is now currently a motion picture?
Ira Hayes.
Thank you. Number three, who plays him in the motion picture? Do you happen to know?
I think it's Tony Curtis.
Tony Curtis. Do you know the name of the picture, number three?
The Outsider.
Thank you. Number one?
Betty.
Number two, there was a story that picture was phony. On what was that story based?
Well, the story is not true because the picture was not phony. There was a picture taken later on, which was set up by me, which we had all the fellows come around, and I took that picture, but the original picture was not phony. It would have been better if it had been set up, I think.
Number one was the...
Johnny.
Number three, how many of the... there were what, five?
Six.
Six. How many of those gentlemen are alive today?
Two, sir.
You know the names of the two that are still living?
Yes. Pharmacist Mate Bradley and Private Renee Gagnon.
Mr. Rosenthal, number one, what is the highest point in altitude on Iwo Jima?
Mount Suribachi, which is about 550 feet in altitude.
About 550 feet?
Yeah.
I was going to ask what Betty asked about being staged. Was there more than number two? Was there more than one picture taken of that actual raising? Was there just one?
Yes, there was a second picture taken when the flag was up.
In other words, which picture is actually shown? Is on the stamp? Is that
the one? No, the first one when the pole was going up, when they were raising the pole, was the one that's on the stamp.
Peggy.
Number one, on the way back to take the second picture, didn't something happen to one of the six?
No.
Number two, wasn't one of the six killed on the way back to, you know, to going back to have the second picture taken or like to get the citation?
Oh, you mean the citation in later on in Washington, you mean?
No.
Because three of the men were lost in combat.
I see. Number three, is this statue's on the banks of the Potomac River, but is it not also in Arlington Cemetery?
Yes, it's part of the Marine Field in Arlington.
Number one.
Right, that's all the time we have. Very memorable occasion we had here, but it's time for us to memorialize it ourselves with our ballots. So will you kindly do so now? Mark your ballots without consultation. Vote as you do so for number one, number two, or number three.
I think number two looks like he might be a photographer.
Johnny, what about your ballot?
I haven't really the slightest idea. I voted for number three because I know a fellow named Sam Rosenthal, and number three looks a good deal like Sam Rosenthal.
Well, like a refreshment of good sound reasoning behind these votes. Peggy, what about yours?
Well, I voted for number two just because I have a feeling.
Not a Sam feeling, just a feeling. All right, there we have it. The votes are in and the minds are made up. And now it's time for us to find out who's right and who's wrong, which we will do in a little different way, because here to show us which one of these men is the real Joe Rosenthal is one of the men who appears in that actual picture, former Marine Corporal Rene Gagnon. Mr. Gagnon, would you do us the favor, sir, of pointing out which of these three gentlemen is the real photographer? Mr. Gagnon, it's a great privilege and pleasure to meet you, sir, and to have you here with us tonight. Exactly which one of the men are you in that picture?
I'm the first one standing up behind the staff.
First one standing up?
Yes, there's one kneeling over and the first one standing. First of course, there's two shoulder to shoulder, but it's on the other side. You just see the helmet.
I see. All you can see in the picture is your helmet?
Just the helmet.
Well, you'd have a hard time getting away if somebody else wanted to claim it, wouldn't you? No identifying marks. Well, you must be mighty proud of your part in that historic event, I'm sure.
Yes, sir, but I am.
No prouder than we are to have you here tonight, sir, and to meet you and have you part of our show. Thank you very much.